Hey guys, welcome to BIM Learning for You. Today we are going to discuss the top 10 tips for Revit performance. Top 10. Purge. Purge your Revit file of unused content. Sweep the broom through your project and get rid of all unused families, groups, materials, etc. These can really add up to increase your file size, so if you don't need them, delete them. You can always bring them back if you need to later on. In the Manage tab, you can find the Purge Unused option. Well, 9. Elevation and Section Far Clip. Each section and elevation should have a far clip active. Set the far clip so that it only extends far enough for the curved information to show in the drawing. By activating the far clip, you reduce the data processed in generating the drawing, which gives better performance and, in some cases, better startup. Number 8. Delete unnecessary views. Try to keep your project as lean as possible. Having too many views can slow down your project, so make sure you delete all temporary or unnecessary views. Number 7. Groups. Groups always seem like a great idea at first, but they wind up functioning differently than you expect them to. Use groups sparingly and with good reason. If it seems like your group could be made into a static family, it probably should be. Also, be wary of types of components you are grouping together. Wall-hosted items like sinks or doors can have issues when they are grouped away from their host. Number 6. Delete unused design options. Design options can slow down the model. Even though they may not be active and visible, when changes are made within the main model, all design options have to update. To unburden the model, remove any unused design options. Similarly, maintaining unplaced views adds unnecessary data to the model. This can contribute to slow down the model performance and large file sizes. So, delete them. Number 5. Link your files with, when possible, do not import. There are many instances when you either have to use information from other software package, drawing or project in your current model. There are two ways to do this in Revit. In my opinion, the wrong way and the right way. For example, you have a CAD topography surface you want to use for your site. You can either import it, which will literally add all the information from that file into your model. Meaning if your CAD file was 5 MB, you have just added an extra 5 MB onto your Revit model. Not good, right? If you, on the other hand, choose to link your CAD file to your Revit model, you are only creating a link in your Revit to an external file, significantly reducing the impact on performance in your Revit model. When linking files, you must pay attention to where the path is located and make sure that it does not change in the mid project. Number 4. Turn snaps off. On the Manage ribbon and then use the keyboard shortcuts to selectively turn on the snaps when needed. This stops Revit from continuously looking for snap points when you are trying to navigate the model or draw new geometry. Number 3. Close worksheets. When working in your project, most of the time you will be focusing on just one area at a time. To help speed up your session, it is a good idea to close any worksheet that you are not currently working in. Number 2. Resolve warnings. Revit can spend a lot of resources trying to compute errors and give warnings. Resolving these warnings can help speed up your session. It's always better to resolve warnings as they arise, rather than trying to tie them up at the end. This is the main point, the system requirements. If you have followed all the tips thus far, make sure your software and hardware are also working at this level. Autodesk Revit models usually store and handle a significant amount of BIM data. When working with this data, it is important to make sure that the system meets the requirements needed by Revit for a good performance. Thank you for watching. Subscribe to our YouTube channel. Thank you for your support.